Good day. In this video, we are going to see a very simple digital trainer kit which is in virtual mode. For that, go to Google and just type logic.ly and press the enter button. So it will be going to the site logic.ly. Here in this site, I'm just clicking the button try online. So if this button is pressed, it will enter into the logic.ly site and it gives some hint. Let me close the hints, and this is the board which is available to simulate our circuits. So here in the left panel, we are having some input controls and output controls, logic gates and flip-flops, along with the labels pull up and pull down. So these are the essential inputs available. So in a digital circuit, what form of inputs we will be giving? We are going to give a high or low. We can make it a constant, or we want to change the signals as high or low. So these are the requirement. Let us begin with the simple circuit, just a testing of the truth table of the gates. So all the gates are available. Let me take a particular gate. So here I have taken the AND gate. Whenever I am picking a component, that component details will be displayed here. So I can change the input count of the gate by increasing this number. Now the default number is 2 input AND gate. I can increase to 3 input AND gate or 4 input AND gate. So we can make this number to any number. So let me make it as 2 input AND gate. And how I can give the input? I can give, if I want to make a particular input as constant, I can use a high constant or low constant. If I want to change the input, I can take a toggle switch. So I want to check the truth table for all different combinations. So I am picking the toggle switch for input. So when I am picking this toggle switch, the initial condition for toggle switch is display. So let me close it, and I am taking the another toggle switch. And to see the output of the AND gate, let me take the bulb. So these are the basic components. I can just click and drag to make connection. So I am just dragging from input connection and I am making a connection. Now this particular switch is, both the switch are in off condition. All the white line indicates the logic is 0. See, if I press a particular button, now it is changed to blue color. It indicates the logic along that line is 1. So for the AND gate, one input is 1 and another input is 0. So the output is also 0. If I make both the inputs as 1, instantaneously we are getting the output also as 1. So this is how I am checking the truth table of AND gate. Similarly, we can begin our digital trainer experiments by checking all the truth tables of the logic gates. If you want to do the similar thing on the flip-flops, let me select this circuit and delete. And let me do a simple experiment on verification of the characteristics table of flip-flop. So let me take a D flip-flop, which is a basic flip-flop. Here if you see, in a D flip-flop, what are all the basic inputs that we need to give us? The D input, clock, and there is an output Q and Q bar. Apart from that, we will be having preset and clear. So here, what is preset and clear? So in this particular design, in this site, both the signals are low level signal. So if I give a low signal, let me connect a bulb for Q and Q bar. So initially I am just making a connection, and if I make the clear signal to 0, so clear is a low logic signal, and if I give 0 to the clear, the output Q is clear. So Q equal to 0, Q bar equal to 1. Now, without giving the input, I am just clearing the flip-flop. If I want to set the flip-flop to 1, I have to give this signal to preset. Here the preset signal also a low level signal. So if I give 0 to preset, then now the flip-flop is being set. So Q equal to 1, Q bar equal to 0. So this is how we need to use the preset and clear signal. If you want to test the characteristic of this particular flip-flop, I should not give any preset signal and I should not give any clear signal. So I am defaultly making the both the signals as logic high, so that I am not going to work with clear or preset signal. Now I am going to give an input to the D flip-flop through a toggle switch. So I am connecting the input to the D flip-flop. Now I need to connect a clock. So here the clock default time is 1000 milliseconds. To visualize clearly, let me make it as 5000 milliseconds. So that the signals are slow. The clock signals are now really they are slow. So now I am connecting to the, and for this particular flip-flop, whenever this high signal is coming from clock, it is going to respond for the input. So the now input is 0. For each clock pulse, when it goes high, it will respond. Now I am making the signal as 1. When the clock goes high, let us write. So when the clock goes high, the output is equal to D. So if I place 1, the output is 1. When the next clock occurs, when I make it 0, when the next clock occurs, then it will be converted to. So let us wait for the next positive edge trigger clock. Now the edge trigger occurred and the value is stored in the flip-flop. This is how we can check the truth table of D flip-flop.